This month, China's Ministry of Commerce announced further export controls on graphite, specifically to the US. The measures came a day after President Joe Biden announced restrictions on Chinese access to advanced US technology. The controls come 1 year after China introduced rules that required exporters to obtain special licenses to export graphite products. That caused graphite prices to rise, but that's unlikely to happen this time around.
And we've now had an immediate implementation of the export regulations as soon as it was announced. So the trend we saw last time of increased procurement ahead of the regulations being implemented and increasing prices, I don't think we'll see that this time around, considering the implementation is imminent. However, when you look at the long-term impact of these, I think it's really just put into light as it did last year, but it's also more so now in regards to rising geopolitical tensions, that China has got such a stronghold on the market of graphite, but not only just graphite, but also the whole supply chain.
Graphite is used in the anode of lithium-ion batteries. China dominates production of both natural graphite as well as synthetic graphite, the two materials that are blended to make battery anode materials. It produces 93% of the anode materials that go into lithium-ion batteries, according to Benchmark.
When you look at the material that's being produced outside of China, with regard to anode material, that still touches China further up the supply chain. So much, 99% of the anode supply chain touches China currently in some way.
The additional controls on graphite are part of broader measures that limit the export of dual-use items, those which can be used for civil or military purposes.
It is just a play from China to show this stronghold that they have. The outright ban is only for military end-use applications. We have heard reports that this could encompass 99.999% carbon content graphite, which is high purity used for the military end use markets, such as in missile nozzles and some nuclear applications as well. However, nothing has been publicly announced on that as of yet. A lot of the graphite material that is directly exported from China to the US is for non-battery applications.
Still, the restrictions are only likely to accelerate the build-out of a graphite and anode supply chain for batteries in the US, which has already seen significant investment following President Joe Biden's Inflation Reduction Act.
Since the US IRA announced in August 2022, we've seen 700,000 tons of anode capacity within the US, which is a stark contrast to what was before. It's a massive notable increase from pre-IRA levels.
Yet the US is still far from self-sufficiency.
700,000 tons is a huge amount when you're talking about the US market. But then if you look over to the Chinese market, we see 700,000 tons per annum announced in 6 month periods. While it's being announced and there's positive movements in the US, if you look at the other side into China, they're doing these expansion plans, they're doing these capacity announcements at much larger rates and at more frequent intervals as well.
As a result, China is still likely to have over 80% of the anode market by the end of the decade, according to Benchmark.